Shared resources are nice, but what kind of shared responsibilities are you giving to your community members? Hi, I'm Kiki Letalien of AssociationChat.com. And on this episode of Why Community Matters, I talk with Josh Hotsenpiller, CEO of JUNO, about shared responsibility and why it's such a critical component for healthy community.
So there was an awesome study done on something as simple as tug of war. And they did a study on how the intensity and the force that an individual uses when it's one-on-one versus many-on-many. Mm-hmm. And what they found was kind of the law of attrition. When more people are doing it, they'll do it. They've got it. What happens in organizations, especially membership ones, is every member kind of assumes another member is going to do it because we've not assigned them a unique responsibility to get us there. Hey guys, this is where we're going and why it matters. And this is what I need you to do to help us get there. So as you start to lay out your organization, it starts with where we go and why does it matter? The next one is I've got to start giving responsibility away if I'm going to get maximum investment and outcomes from my people. These are tough things. I mean, vision is not easy. And, you know, people are like, oh, just tell us where we're going. And you're like, gosh, I wish it was that easy.
Right.
But here's another thing. Building an ecosystem of opportunity for people is hard work. Like you actually have to go, oh my gosh, I've got to start figuring out how to give things away and how to create a compelling enough opportunity to give enough stuff away. So this is not easy stuff, but it's what neither is sustaining community.
So remember, if there's no unique role given, people won't feel that their contributions have any kind of value. They need shared responsibility in order to feel like they're an important part of a community that matters.